First of all, I'd like to introduce some very important guests in our audience tonight. From the world champion New York Yankees baseball team, led by their manager Casey Stengo, and their star outfielder, Mick Mantle. Would you fellas stand up and take a bow? And also in our audience tonight, appearing on Broadway for the last 26 weeks, the star of the hit musical My Fair Lady, the lovely and talented Julie Andrews. Let's have a big hand for Julie Andrews. Now, our first star tonight, star of the silver screen in many fine westerns in recent years, Mr. Jimmy Stewart. Jimmy, come on out here. Let's have a fine welcome for Jimmy Stewart. Jimmy, I wonder if you have any stories about a Western shoot, something that happened while you were filming. Well, yes, Ed. In fact, we were up in Alaska, and some of our fellows on the fella pro, they like to hunt. And the thing is, you say, there was this guy, he was named Tex, and he went out one morning from the cabin, and he says, I'm going to get a grizzly bear. And I said, well, whoa, wait a minute, fella. Where's your gun? He says, in Texas, we use our bare hands. The little time went by, and I hear this yelling, open the door, open the door. And I look out the cabin window, and here's this guy running up with a grizzly bear chasing him. So I open the door, he runs in, and the grizzly bear runs after him. He runs out again, and the thing is, he slams the door, and he yells, hey fellas, you skin that one, and I'll get you another one. Thank you very much, Jimmy Stewart. Movie star, an icon in the horror movie films, Mr. Boris Karloff. Let's have a fine welcome for Boris Karloff. My name is Boris Karloff. I created the monster Frankenstein, but I made a boo-boo. He got away. Come back, Frankie. Come back. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Boris Karloff. Next on our program, co-star of that wonderful comedy series, All in the Family, Edith Bunker. Come on out here, Edith.
Why is that?
Well, you see, one day, Michael was going out the door to work, and on one hand, he had a glove, but none on the other. And Archie says, Michael, how come you got a glove on one hand and not on the other? And he said, Michael said, well, today,
Western movies, Mr. John Wayne. Let's have a fine welcome. there, Pilgrim. I mean, Ed. You can call me the Duke, you know. John, I understand that you grew up very poor, didn't you? Well, I didn't grow up with a silver spoon in my mouth like you. And by the way you talk, it looks like you still got it in there. We were so poor that one Christmas, all we had to eat was a bottle of aspirin. It didn't fill us up, but none of us kids had a headache for years. Ladies and gentlemen, John Wayne. A Ruby Shoe tonight. We have that famous, well-known color commentator of Monday Night Football, Howard Cosell. Let's have a fine welcome to Howard Cosell. Hello, Ed. And I guess you're going to ask me how's the champ, Muhammad Ali, tonight. So I brought Muhammad with me, and you can ask him for it. You can ask him yourself how's training going for the big fight against Joe Frazier. Come on out here, Muhammad.
I look like a butterfly and I sting like a bee. And my name is Muhammad Ali. I'm gonna mess up Joe Frazier so bad that even Vitalis won't help
him. Thank you very much, Howard and Muhammad. From time to time, we have dignitaries in town come in town this week from our great neighbor to the north, attending the United Nations conference. Is their Prime Minister Pierre, the Honorable Pierre Elliott Trudeau? Pierre, come on out here. And by the way, Pierre, how is your wife? Margaret's her name, isn't it? Margaret is her name. But I would prefer if you don't mention my wife. When I was in Scotland last year, someone asked, how's Margaret? And I turned to them and I said, look, how's the Loch Ness Monster? is it true, Pierre, that you're quite popular in Canada, aren't you? Well, I have reasonable support, especially in eastern Canada and Quebec, but in the west I'm not very popular. So in the last election I said to the people of western Canada, if anybody votes for me in the next election, I would send them a cookie. Well, how did that turn out? Well, the result was we didn't elect one Liberal in the West, and I had a nasty letter from a lady in Cumberland saying, your cookies are terrible. Thank you very much, Pierre. Now, final act on our show tonight, those lovable characters from Sesame Street, Bert and Ernie. Come on out here, fellas, and let's have a fine hand for Bert.
Hello, Ed. You know my friend Bert? Well, we'd like to sing you a song. But first of all, Bert, can I borrow your rubber ducky?
Oh, Ernie, you always ask to borrow my rubber ducky, and you never give it back until I beg you. Oh, all right.
Thanks, Bert. Rubber ducky, you're the one. You made bath time so much fun. Rubber ducky, you're awfully good to me. You'll go for it. Rubber ducky, you're so fine. I'm so glad that you are mine. Rubber ducky, you're my very best friend. It's true. Every day when I go to the tubby, I have a hell that's cute and yellow and chubby. Rubber ducky, you make noise when I snore. You're full of joys, full of joys. When I squeeze you, you make noise. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bert and Ernie. watching our show tonight. Next week we have a very big treat. We have the Beatles, John, Ringo, Paul, and George. Thank you for tuning in, and drive safely, and we'll see you next week on the CBS network. Thank you very much.